Hi, I'm your state senator, Linda Evans Parlette. Happy to represent you as the 12th legislative district, which, if you recall, is Chelan County, Douglas County, part of Grant, and part of Okanagan. So today is day 53 in the legislative session. We have reached the halfway point for this legislative session. Hopefully, I mean we will get out on time, and this session will be 105 days. It's hard for me to believe that this is the 8th week. It seems like I've been here longer than that. So I will have to tell you that a surprise to me is that I have sponsored 23 bills in this legislative session. I think that's a record. Many of these are constituent request bills, and unfortunately, I didn't count them up until last night. Four of those bills are NTIB. That means necessary to implement the budget. One of those has to do with the extension of the tax incentives for Alcoa. As you know, we have one of two Alcoa plants in the state of Washington. So hopefully that bill will be necessary to implement the budget, and we will be able to pass that before we end. I want to tell you that most of the bills that I've sponsored, other than the NTIB bills, have moved along through the process. One of them has to do with hydraulic permits. That's 5204. That is connected with the Carlton Complex fire. So if an emergency occurs, and the governor has actually stated that that county, in this case Okanagan County, is considered in the disaster relief emergency type situation, well, those people who have to apply for a hydraulic permit would not have to pay the $100 again because of it is an emergency. So that's just one example. Another example of a bill that passed recently has to do with the Stehekin School District. That school district has been in existence for 107 years. Only 8 times in 107 years have the population of the school gone down below 5. State law says if you go below 5, the school district has to dissolve. So actually, we would like to fix state law and say take an average of the last 3 years so we don't have to dissolve a school district. As you know, Lake Chelan is 55 miles long. There is no way these kids can go to school elsewhere, starting in kindergarten, and be connected with their families. So this is a very important bill, and I hope we can get it through the House. So there are other bills too, but rather than go into the details, I would say the most significant thing that the Senate has done this week is pass a transportation package. Now that's always controversial when you pass a revenue package, but in the past, 2003, there was the nickel fund, 2005, a 9.5 cent gas tax increase, which I did not vote for. This package is different. Number one, unlike the other two, there is money in it for maintenance and preservation. We have to address this. The Department of Transportation doesn't have any funding to take care of those roads that need to be updated a bit, whether it's chip seal or something else. So that's really important. But really, the transportation reforms, that is key. There will be no increase of gas tax unless we do pass some of these significant reforms. They all passed off the floor of the Senate. Time will tell what happens in the House. We need a commitment from the governor that, in fact, he will sign these important reforms. So that's about it on that. Significant that we pass that package out with bipartisan support on Monday of this week. And again, we're only halfway through the session. Things will change. Thank you for the honor of representing you. Until then, I'm proud to be your state senator.